Hello and welcome back to the Homestead. Hey, we're automated here on the Homestead. We don't want to be prisoners on our homestead. We're getting ready to go out of town this weekend. We're going to go to Oregon for a bit for my wife's birthday. I'm not going to tell you how old she is. She may hit me in the mouth for that, so we're going to keep that to ourselves. But we need to make sure that we automate things so we don't have to rely on other people to make sure that our garden gets watered. Now, a lot of the watering issues can be resolved simply by heavy mulch. But we've been pretty hot over here in the last few days. We've been getting up close to 100 degrees. And what I found is that most of the moisture stays in the ground, but you want to keep that moisture going. You don't want to go through really wet and then dry spells. You want that moisture to stay in. Plus, we've got a lot of plants that we've got in pots here. Still have a lot of plants to put in the ground, and we even picked up some the other day when we went and picked up some irises, some mint. The chickens are already doing their thing where they're scratching up the straw and they're doing their thing, manuring the straw and getting it ready for mulch for next year. Setting up automation in your chicken area is also a good idea. Here what we've done is we've taken a 5-gallon bucket and we've put these 3-inch 45s on. Some people use 3-inch 90s, but the 45s work just as well. We don't have any food to speak of anyways on the ground that's being wasted. And you'll see there where there's plenty of food within. Let me get closer where they can actually reach it. We filled this up a day or so ago, and we still have quite a bit of food left. This will last them until we get back. I also invested in an automatic waterer from Little Giant, and I'll put a link to this on the show notes. You'll see here where I've connected it to an igloo, and I think later we'll make a video on how to set this up, but this thing has stayed pretty well full. I might try to adjust it to get a higher water level, but we'll see. It's a pretty cool little device. The main thing is the animals. We do need some help with that, and that's what making good relations with the neighbors are all about. Have the neighbor come over in the morning, let the chickens out. Have them go before they go to bed, put the chickens back to bed. So that's pretty easy. But asking someone to come by and water an acre of ground, not a good idea. Not for good relations anyways. We want to automate this thing. Right now the front area is irrigated with overhead sprinklers, and I'll eventually change that to where I put polypipe in the ground so I don't have to use these water hoses. But you see here how we've set up our iris bed. And I know irises, you can't eat them, you can only look at them, but they bring in pollinators. They're an early bloomer and they tend to bring in pollinators pretty early. And that's what we're shooting for as far as pollination for our other plants. I set up these irrigation boxes here. There's 6 valves on each. As you can see down here, there's 3 and then there's 3 over here. I've never done this before. This was the first time I've ever set up irrigation like this, and I think I've gotten pretty good at it. First attempt, it works out pretty well. You'll see I've got a pipe poking out of the ground, because right now we're using our house well for our house water to irrigate the property, and that's not, those pumps are expensive, and the last thing you want to do is burn up a pump. And so what I've done is I've put access here on a 1-inch PVC pipe down to the main polypipe that feeds the entire irrigation to the property. There is no irrigation right now to the back other than what I've installed. I'll eventually set up more beds and thereby need more irrigation, more watering systems coming out here. You can see all this area right here that's cut back, and all that green is not grass. All that green is morning glory and weed. All that's got to go. But we'll have beds put in and we'll need irrigation to all those. And all this blank area here will have irrigation as well. Strawberry bed's doing great right now. Started out rough, but I think now it's starting to come into its own. But I don't like the raised bed look. I don't like the boxes. It's just not doing it for me. I like these rocks surrounding an area where I can put plants and then make them a little less regular, a little less blocky. And I think I'm going to do just like this bed here and make multiple beds all the way up in here using rock to edge and set up an individual sprinkler per bed. The hotbeds are finished and the irrigation to the hotbeds are set up. What I did is I ran a 1-inch pipe down into the ground and I set up these little angles and I put them on flood irrigation. You can see here these flood emitters rather, and you can see here this little emitter, and these go off on a timer as well to flood all 4 of these from the irrigation system that we set up in the front. Right here. And that also feeds over and waters our plants that are still in pots over there.
Hey, it's going to be a hot one today, July the 4th, 2017. It's going to get up to about 100 degrees today. And one of the problems we're having is shade for our chickens. We've got our sunchokes that provide quite a bit of shade, but more in the late afternoons. You going to sit there all day or what? I think what we're going to do is we're going to build a structure eventually, probably in the next week or so, a 4x8 lean-to that can give him some structure that we can actually put some sides on to block the sun in those directions. What they'll do is they'll huddle up right around the side of the chicken coop here. And the shade is just not enough to really keep all seven birds nice and shaded. But they're scratching around, they're doing their thing. The one thing I found is that the earwigs love this straw. They just find all kinds of earwigs moving around like crazy up in the straw. The sunchokes have gotten to be almost 6 foot tall, and they're providing a lot of shade in the afternoon. When it's boiling hot on this side of the yard, the sunchokes really cover up the shade on this side perfectly. We're down to two rabbits right now, and I think that's where we're going to stay. We may get down to one, but I think two is where we're going to stay. We just don't have the resources here on our homestead to provide shelter for them in an area where they'd like to maybe roam around. It's just too hot out there, and we don't have the whole area fenced in. We live in an open area, pretty well wide open, lots of hawks in this area. And even though that big white one would probably be safe from a hawk attack, the little black one wouldn't. She'd be taken off pretty quickly. And being that we're not going to eat our rabbits, we just don't have any interest in that. The rabbits need to be fed, and that's a resource that we'd have to provide. And the mulch they're providing is just not sufficient in order to justify keeping our bunnies. We got lucky, and two of the other bunnies were given away today to a couple over in the Boise area who really are interested in permaculture concepts and have a nice shaded area for the two bunnies to run around in. The two bunnies we have now, we picked up another dog cage here. And with the one that we already have in the garage, we're going to go ahead and start working on our worm bin bathtub and get this thing set up and maybe start composting on a bigger scale than what we're looking at now. We'll clean this up because we already have a little bit of resource here to be able to start the worm bin with. We'll probably soak this and then let it drain a bit and then put the worms right in. The worm bin we've been using here, we picked up a few years ago on Craigslist from a couple of different people with two different systems that we muddled together and created our worm bin with. So we just got back from the Oregon coast. Wonderful trip, 4 days with the family, enjoyed ourselves. Here are a few pictures that we took while we were over there on the coast. We noticed that it was about 40 to 45 degrees cooler over there. Lots more moisture. We always knew that they get more rain. Tons of water, but we also saw people using automated sprinklers just like we do over here. They don't have to do them as often. Here, you have to water pretty much every day. When you're talking about 90 to 100 degrees in the summer with a 10% humidity, things dry out pretty fast. So you have to keep things covered with mulch, you have to keep things watered, and automation is the way to go. Having so many chores that you just can't walk away from your homestead for a little while just really starts to add some resentment, and that's the last thing you want. So we're pretty much done with phase one, what we're calling phase one of the property development here. Phase two is going to have to be with the perennials, putting the rest of the plants in the ground and starting the garden beds.